Tantor Audio, a division of Recorded Books, presents Trauma-Sensitive Yoga in Therapy, Bringing the Body into Treatment, by David Emerson. Foreword by Jennifer West, Ph.D. Narrated by Daniel Henning. Publisher's note: this audiobook refers to figures included in the print and ebook editions of the book. Foreword. Originally, in the first couple sessions, part of me was hyper-alert of being in the space and distrustful of yoga. You know, what is this really going to do for me? I was very skeptical. Over time, I know it's kind of strange, but it's almost as if my mind became more connected to my thoughts and what I did to my body. Yoga gave me structure, like a place to start building or becoming more aware. I think it gave me a starting place. Trauma-sensitive yoga research participant. As a helping professional, even if you've never used yoga with a client before, you can likely imagine a reaction such as the one depicted before. In fact, you may even share some of the skepticism described in the first part, or have similar questions about the use of yoga in treatment. Common questions I have been asked include the following. If other forms of therapy have not successfully eliminated symptoms, how is yoga going to be any different? How can yoga help in healing the deep wounds of trauma? How can yoga supplement or be integrated in the psychotherapy process? Is yoga a worthy complement to psychotherapy? By way of introducing David Emerson's practical and creative ideas of how to integrate yoga into the therapy room, I will attempt to answer these questions and offer my thoughts on how and why yoga is an important and useful adjunct to therapy. My perspective and ideas are based on my clinical experiences and research with adult female survivors of childhood interpersonal trauma, referred to as complex trauma. My journey into yoga began in 2004, after a significant personal loss. Practicing yoga became a source of hope and healing during a time of turmoil. Like many of the clients I now work with, I found a physical, psychological, and emotional outlet through yoga, and my personal journey quickly became an integral part of my professional practice. As a counseling psychologist who studies post-trauma recovery and healing, I always look for ways to help my clients decrease symptoms and improve overall health and wellness. After noticing yoga's profound effects on my own emotional well-being and recovery, I began to wonder how people struggling with complex trauma might respond to yoga. Indeed, a growing body of literature has unequivocally shown the benefits of yoga for many medical problems, for example, diabetes, arthritis, fibromyalgia, cancer, and mental health issues, for example, depression, anxiety. So it seemed reasonable to imagine possible benefits for trauma survivors. As I ventured toward using yoga as a therapeutic outlet, I took yoga teacher training to educate myself further and began researching yoga as a treatment for post-traumatic stress disorder, PTSD. In collaboration with Bessel van der Kolk's Trauma Center, I focused my research on examining the effects of TSY on adult survivors of complex trauma. What we know about complex trauma is that symptoms that arise in the aftermath can disrupt functioning well into adulthood and pervade all domains of a person's life. When our self-protective capacities are consistently overwhelmed by repeated exposure to trauma, it can be toxic to our bodies, and survivors often find themselves in a cycle of hyperarousal and disassociative numbing. The experience of complex trauma and resulting autonomic instability can lead to a feeling of being out of control within one's own body and life. Trauma survivors describe intolerable physical sensations and somatic complaints, problems with affect and impulse regulation, deficits in attention capacities, poor interoceptive awareness, and negative self-perception. This complex array of symptoms can pose significant challenges in treatment. After all, how can we expect clients to successfully engage in talk therapy when they disconnect from inner experiences? struggle to stay connected to their present experiences, and lack the skills to tolerate affect elicited by trauma-related stimuli, such as when asked to process traumatic memories. Psychotherapy can be effective in treating various aspects of PTSD, such as confronting relational difficulties in a supportive environment, identifying unhealthy patterns, and setting goals for engaging in self-care. However, physiological symptoms, somatic complaints, and a lack of interoceptive awareness may be more difficult to treat with top-down approaches, that is, cognitively oriented treatments focusing on thoughts and emotions. This leads us back to the question about how yoga can help. How is yoga going to be any different from other treatments? Yoga, defined here as a combination of physical forms, focused breathing, and purposeful attention or mindfulness, seems to be a useful complement to trauma treatment because it directly targets the very symptoms that other approaches struggle to address by using the body purposefully, that is, a bottom-up approach. TSY, in particular, aims to cultivate awareness of the mind-body connection and to build self-regulation skills to address the ways in which trauma is held in the body. A randomized controlled trial, RCT, conducted by Bessel van der Kolk and colleagues, examined the effects of TSY on women with complex trauma who were unresponsive to traditional psychotherapy. Women in the 10-week TSY course were more likely than women in the control group to no longer meet criteria for PTSD post-treatment. The TSY group also showed significant decreases in depressive symptoms and negative tension reduction behaviors, for example, self-injury. Furthermore, a long-term follow-up conducted by Allison Rhodes found that the frequency of continuing yoga practice, regardless of group assignment in the study, was a significant predictor of long-term outcomes. At 1 to 3 years post-treatment, women who practiced yoga following the study were more likely to show a loss of a PTSD diagnosis and greater reductions in PTSD and depressive symptoms. These studies suggest that the addition of TSY to treatment may lead to long-term improvement in symptoms that had previously been considered unresponsive to other interventions. How can yoga help to heal the deep wounds of trauma? While past research has demonstrated the profound effects of TSY as an effective complement to traditional psychotherapy, the specific mechanisms by which TSY generates such change were still unclear. In an attempt to gain some understanding, I talked with participants 2 months after they completed the 10 weeks of TSY. Using semi-structured interviews in a one-on-one setting, I asked the women to share their personal experiences of TSY and the perceived changes in their lives due to their use of TSY. Throughout the interviews, the women attested to the tenaciousness of complex trauma symptoms and their non-responsiveness to years of treatment. Through their experiences with TSY, they reported symptom reduction, improved quality of life, and personal empowerment. Through the sharing of their stories, the women provide some answers to the question about how yoga can help in healing the deep wounds of trauma. I outline some of their insights later. Consistent with typical symptoms of complex trauma, participants in the study described how, prior to the TSY program, they often felt disconnected or disassociated from their present reality. However, the integration of purposeful attention with physical postures and focused breathing seemed to improve participants' capacity for present moment awareness. They became increasingly able and willing to notice how they were feeling in their body and formed greater tolerance for emotional states and bodily sensations, as they could experience them in a safe way rather than from the lens of past trauma. One participant said she started to be able to recognize emotions, feel what's inside, instead of just trying to get rid of it. In addition to greater interoceptive awareness and tolerance of inner sensations, TSY also instilled a sense of ownership over one's physical body that many women had lost through their traumatic experiences. Women started to recognize that their bodies belonged to them, that their bodies were under their control, and that they could be safe in their bodies. This involved a literal awareness of an embodied self, an acceptance of one's body with less judgment and criticism, as well as a sense of being in charge of how to move, use, and treat one's body. For many of the participants, a growing awareness of ownership and control over one's body also led to appreciation for one's body, including a deeper sense of responsibility for self-care and the tendency to listen to my body a lot more now. Similarly, participants said they began to feel more confident in identifying and employing appropriate behavioral responses in emotionally difficult situations, including when they triggered or experienced flashbacks. Through TSY, they were able to build skills for emotional regulation through the use of physical postures and breath, and have these ways to soothe and comfort myself, and I don't have to be stuck in the flashbacks. The increased ability for regulation of internal states also inspired a sense of control in one's life and, in turn, hopes for new possibilities in the future. For some, this included willingness to take action to improve their health, for example, stop smoking or drinking. And for others, this consisted of making changes to improve quality of life, for example, pursuing professional passions. Like many survivors of complex trauma, the women also experienced long-lasting damage to their sense of self, such as feelings of shame, hopelessness, and worthlessness. However, through TSY, participants began to change their language about themselves, express less self-judgment, and even cultivate self-acceptance. Likewise, participants acknowledged an appreciation for all they had been through. Issues of interpersonal functioning, for example, isolation, lack of trust, unhealthy boundaries, resulting from complex trauma, caused some of the most significant pain for participants. However, as participants began to feel more connected to and accepting of themselves, they also began feeling more comfortable engaging authentically in relationships and setting healthy boundaries. While the TSY classes focused specifically on present-moment experiences in the body, the women in the study described benefits both on and off the mat. The women gained skills for finding a calm presence in and out of class. They developed a stronger connection to themselves and to other people in their lives, and they recognized their ability to choose how to move their bodies and choose the direction of their lives. How can TSY supplement or be integrated in the psychotherapy process? The impact of TSY on trauma survivors can clearly be quite significant. Ideally, the integration of TSY with ongoing psychotherapy would allow for the synthesis of top-down and bottom-up processing in the treatment setting. Such an approach rests on the belief that a greater capacity for emotion regulation, interoceptive awareness, and self-acceptance may facilitate deeper interpersonal connections, including the therapy relationship. Indeed, some participants expressed greater ability for emotional expression and exploration in therapy for those reasons. Integrating TSY into the therapy room may seem daunting at first. You may wonder about space limitations or whether clients will feel comfortable doing yoga forms in the therapy room. While this book will walk you through all the ins and outs and address these curiosities in detail, here are some brief thoughts regarding such concerns. From a practical standpoint, many of the movements and forms in TSY are done in a chair, making this approach easily adaptable to the individual therapy room. The information contained in this book will provide you with many examples. Additionally, some of the study participants offered insight into specific attributes of the teacher and environment that made them feel comfortable and able to fully engage in moving their bodies in a therapeutic setting. I would suggest that these characteristics would also be important for a therapist in a clinical setting. The tone of the teacher's voice, as well as the words the teacher chose, were quite important to the facilitation of a sense of safety and comfort. More specifically, A gentle tone and environment of acceptance was appreciated as the teacher was perceived as extraordinarily kind and patient, and never asked the women to do more than we could. Another important aspect was the use of invitatory language, for example, if you like, or when you feel ready, which highlights choice, presence, and awareness of the body. Furthermore, providing verbal modifications and alternative forms was an important facet to emphasizing choice and reminding the women to pay attention to what feels right in their body. Using invitatory language and emphasizing choice are often helpful in a psychotherapy setting, and this is certainly the case when incorporating TSY. This may be particularly important if and when a client is not ready to verbally address trauma-related material, as we can offer helpful alternatives and meet clients where they are. A sense of safety in the room was another critical aspect, as it allowed participants to more easily remain engaged in the TSY classes. For example, most participants were grateful for the lights being on, the private room, and the focus on verbal assists versus physical assists. Given the boundaries typically adhered to in therapy, these are likely good guidelines for a psychotherapy setting as well. Is yoga a worthy complement to psychotherapy? The information shared before reflects the valuable role that TSY may have in the treatment of complex trauma. The focus on bottom-up processing in TSY and the emphasis on movement, breath, and bodily sensations seem to help survivors learn to regulate affective arousal by raising awareness of internal states and reorganizing the physiological responses connected to symptoms. Survivors are then more able to experience emotions safely in the present moment. Whereas recalling the trauma may have elicited reactions such as hyperarousal or disassociation in the past, with these physiological changes and skills for self-regulation, participants are able to manage the trauma-related physical sensations or feelings as they arise. Furthermore, for a number of participants, a greater ability to tolerate trauma-related stimuli also meant greater ease in verbally expressing and processing their experiences in psychotherapy. While complex trauma has posed some very difficult challenges for treatment, TSY offers an additional approach for working with symptoms of complex trauma and creates new pathways for healing and personal growth. I hope that this book offers hope and inspiration to you. Remember that yoga is a practice of living the process, and David Emerson is a wonderful guide to have on this journey. Enjoy. You are in good hands. Jennifer West, PhD. Introduction. At this point in history, thanks to the work of many great practitioners and scientists, we have collectively developed a solid understanding about how traumatic experiences affect human beings. The picture, developed by such luminaries as John Eric Erickson, Jean-Martin Charcot, Pierre Janet, John Bowlby, Mary Ainsworth, Lenore Terr, Judith Herman, Rachel Yehuda, Bessel van der Kolk, and many other pioneers, reveals the devastating impacts of trauma on our minds, our bodies, and our relationships. Thanks to continued research in such fields as human development, neurobiology, and epigenetics, our understanding of trauma and its impacts continues to deepen and expand. However, because of the degree of suffering that trauma represents in human terms, from survivors of war, violence, torture, human trafficking, and terror, to survivors of chronic childhood abuse and neglect, to victims of domestic violence and sexual assault all across the globe, the time has come for us to pivot from our understanding of trauma toward developing and implementing new effective treatments. Too many studies that indicate the impacts of trauma tend to resort to the hope of psychopharmacological solution. While perhaps drugs can take the edge off of symptoms and may even one day erase memories, it is extremely doubtful that they will ever truly heal people from the most insidious reality of relational trauma. that we are deliberately hurt and betrayed by our fellow human beings, most egregiously by those who were supposed to protect us. TSY is intended most pointedly for people who have experienced this kind of interpersonal trauma, and though I allude to it here, I will explain the rationale in detail. My basic argument throughout this book is that if we want to treat people who've experienced interpersonal trauma effectively, we must use the clinical knowledge available to us and be open to new interventions that recognize the deep and complex nature of these traumatic experiences, and not reduce trauma to a set of symptoms that can be medicated away, or for which a simple change in cognitive frame or behavioral patterns will suffice. Our treatments must match the complexity and nuance of trauma itself, and one aspect of the whole person that must not be overlooked or minimized is the experience of being embodied. For it is the body, the result of billions of years of evolution, that ultimately defines us as being human. In this book, I explain the fundamentals of trauma-sensitive yoga, TSY, an intervention based in and completely reliant on the body, as an adjunctive treatment for individuals impacted by trauma. My intention is to offer a rationale for its use, describe the evidence accumulated on its behalf so far, and provide specific techniques and practices that can be utilized by clinicians and clients as they work together to heal one of the most insidious wounds a human being can experience. In 2003, yoga was first used as an adjunctive treatment for trauma at the Trauma Center in Brookline, Massachusetts. From its beginning, the Trauma Center Yoga Program has been a collaborative effort among yoga teachers, clinicians, neuroscientists, and our clients. In keeping with our desire to accumulate objective data as to the efficacy of our intervention, one of the first steps we took was to create a small pilot study to measure in a clinical setting the impact of yoga on adult survivors of chronic childhood abuse and neglect. Our concern was that our clients as a group reported explicitly or demonstrated in various ways a deep and abiding hatred for their bodies, and we did not see a talk-based approach to therapy as being an adequate way to engage such visceral self-hatred. We thought we could use yoga as a way to help people to befriend their bodies, and that this newfound friendliness would contribute to positive therapeutic outcomes. Therefore, as a team, the first measurement we came up with was a body awareness scale that we could use to measure trauma sufferers' sense of themselves and relationship to their physical beings. This instrument was proprietary, so it had never been used or tested in any other study. But we wanted to see if doing yoga could indeed change a traumatized person's perceptions of her body. In addition, we decided to compare our yoga group to a dialectical behavior therapy, DBT, group that was ongoing in our clinic. We chose DBT for comparison because it is a treatment often used for trauma survivors, and it is primarily a cognitive approach as opposed to our use of yoga, which is primarily physical. I should say that, at this point in our work, we referred to our intervention simply as yoga, or gentle yoga. It wasn't until we really started to establish the theoretical underpinnings and specific methodology behind our approach that we coined the specific term trauma-sensitive yoga. What did we learn as a result of this simple survey and comparison? The yoga group did indeed feel much better about their bodies, and the DBT group felt the same or worse about theirs. This simple result in our small pilot study encouraged us to look further into the possibilities of yoga as a beneficial intervention within the context of trauma treatment. After a few years, we were able to conduct another, slightly larger pilot study that was also positive in terms of body perception, this time comparing our group of trauma survivors with a group without a significant trauma history. Then, in 2009, we were fortunate enough to receive the first grant ever awarded by the National Institutes of Health, NIH, to study the use of yoga for trauma. For the purposes of this study, in order to generate some empirically sound data, we needed to study the effects of our yoga protocol on symptoms associated with post-traumatic stress disorder, PTSD. In this book, I discuss some of the differences between PTSD and other trauma frameworks that, while not officially diagnostic at the time of this writing, nonetheless, more accurately describe the clients for which TSY was developed. These phenomena include complex post-traumatic stress disorder, CPTSD, complex trauma, and developmental trauma, all of which imply a more prolonged exposure to interpersonal trauma, such as a child growing up in an abusive home, as opposed to a single incident, like a car accident, which might result in a PTSD diagnosis. So, while the subjects in our study were survivors of multiple interpersonal traumas, usually beginning in early childhood, everyone also had to qualify for a PTSD diagnosis in order for us to be able to measure any clinically relevant changes that might result after 10 weeks of TSY. Our hypothesis was that TSY participants would show a clinically significant reduction in PTSD symptomology, and that is, in fact, what we found. As a result, we are now able to say that TSY is a promising intervention that has clinical relevance for people in treatment for PTSD. However, as I indicated, there is more to the story because our study also included in-depth interviews with TSY participants that were intended to address the deeper meaning of the TSY experience in relation to the impacts of the complex, long-term interpersonal trauma that our study subjects had experienced. These qualitative interviews, designed and implemented by Jennifer West, and written about by her in the foreword to this book, indeed revealed a more complex picture. PTSD symptoms, in particular, were positively affected after 10 weeks of TSY, and participants also reported that the TSY practice had an impact on their lives beyond the PTSD symptom set. That is, not just symptoms were affected, but also participants experienced themselves in the world and in relation to other people in profoundly new ways. So we concluded that TSY is a relevant intervention for people with PTSD who also have complex trauma histories. This indication, which was revealed in our clinical trials, also aligns with our personal experience of using TSY with complexly traumatized individuals, both male and female, youths and adults, in a wide variety of settings. As a result of our clinical trials, the Trauma Center Yoga Program developed a team of qualified yoga teachers who have collectively taught thousands of TSY sessions since 2003 to groups and individuals suffering from complex trauma, including men and women who grew up in abusive or neglectful environments, as well as survivors of interpersonal violence, sexual assault, war, torture, and more. Over the course of this book, I will share examples of some of these stories with you. Please note that all names used in the stories throughout are pseudonyms, and all of the case stories are composites based on clinical experiences. Ultimately, this book is intended to equip you with information and techniques that you can use in your therapy work. It should not simply serve as an interesting listen, though I hope it is that as well. I begin in Chapter 1 by exploring the principles and parameters of TSY, including how it differs from traditional yoga and other somatic or body-based models of therapy, what its theoretical underpinnings are, which clients can benefit from it most, and who might not be best suited to take advantage of the therapeutic qualities of TSY. The remaining chapters highlight the core aspects of TSY methodology. I will introduce the key concepts of interoception, choice-making, and action-taking, and I examine how to use TSY for such therapeutic goals as working with rhythm and movement, being present, and sensing muscle dynamics. Throughout, I offer to look at both why and how to use various aspects of the treatment under difficult conditions and with different clients in order to maximize the results. Before we delve into the rest of the book, I'd like to highlight an important foundational concept of TSY. You do not need to be a yoga teacher, or really have any prior experience with yoga for that matter, in order to incorporate TSY into your practice. In fact, this book assumes that most listeners are not yoga teachers, but are approaching the material as qualified mental health clinicians or the equivalent. You will rely first and foremost on your clinical training in order to help you establish when TSY might be appropriate for a given client, and then to be able to titrate its use depending on your assessment of its efficacy. That said, the more familiarity you develop with the contents of this book and with specific TSY practices, the more integrity the intervention will have. My assumption is that if you conclude TSY is good for your client, you will also notice that in many fundamental ways it is also good for you, so you will be interested in practicing it for yourself, and thereby strengthen your effectiveness as a facilitator. My hope is that this book, while providing some insight into the nature and impacts of trauma exposure, will be a useful guide to a new treatment modality that has the potential to increase the benefits of your clinical work. Interlude. When the truth is finally recognized, survivors can begin their recovery. Judith Herman, M.D. Historical truth is established by what gets told, not by what actually happened. Daniel N. Stern. Judith Herman, a pioneer in the field of modern trauma study and treatment, suggests that when the truth is finally recognized, survivors can begin their recovery. But what does it mean to recognize truth? What is truth? It may be that the truth Dr. Herman is pointing to here is what one remembers about the past. Indeed, many trauma-informed therapists believe that it is critical for survivors to have access to this kind of truth, that which we remember. However, Daniel N. Stern, a pioneer in the field of developmental psychology, an expert in infant development, and the author of the book The Interpersonal World of the Infant, says that the historical truth is established by what gets told, not by what actually happened. Now, we have to consider our relationship to the truth. Is it something we know, or is it something we tell? In fact, with trauma, there has historically existed a tension between what actually happened and what is told about it. One way to resolve this tension would be to decide what is more important, what is told or what actually happened. TSY was developed in a context where what actually happened matters more than what is told about it. Further, the truth of what actually happened, which Stern calls our attention to, may not be something carried in our explicit memory, and therefore may not be something we can either fully recall or tell someone else about. It may be something that only our body knows and remembers. In fact, it may be something that we cannot speak of, but that we can feel with great clarity right now in our bodies. The eloquence of what we feel but cannot tell. So the truth of memory and cognition is not the only kind of truth that is important to trauma healing. What I feel in my body right now, in the present moment, is at least as important as what I remember about the past and what I tell about it. This book demonstrates that it would be equally valid in the context of trauma treatment to say that when the truth is finally felt and acknowledged in the body, survivors can begin their recovery. 1. What is trauma-sensitive yoga? This chapter will introduce trauma-sensitive yoga, TSY, as a clinical intervention. In order to give as full a picture as possible, I will explore both how TSY differs from mainstream yoga and other somatic models of trauma treatment, as well as the theoretical underpinnings of TSY, within which I provide an overview of the condition that it is intended to treat, called complex trauma. In order to define complex trauma, I will need to review some of the clinical work that has led to the specific framework, as well as some other pertinent clinical material. My presentation of the clinical material is by no means intended to be a complete survey of the literature on trauma. Listeners interested in more in-depth works on the subject will find a good place to start within the references section. In defining complex trauma, I begin at a very particular historical point and focus only on what has led me to develop this approach to treatment. Let's begin by investigating some ways in which TSY differs from more mainstream yoga. How does TSY differ from regular yoga? Yoga is composed of a vast multitude of practices that have a rich, complex, and ancient history. Because yoga as a phenomenon is so convoluted, it would be folly to attempt a concise definition. It is more accurate to say that yoga is supple enough to be many different things to many different people. However, in an effort to find a common denominator, I would suggest that people practice yoga because they want to live more fully. Yoga practitioners are curious about the potential that being alive affords them. So, whether the practices are more mystical and esoteric in nature, or are more grounded and physical, those who take up a yoga practice, whether they are seekers in ancient India or young women in modern-day New York City, share a common bond, which is to know more about themselves and about what it means to be human. Because it is well outside of the scope of this book to go into this.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.